I am honored to be here with all of you to celebrate the success of Class 27. On behalf of Sheriff Bob Johnson, I would like to thank everyone for being here on this very special day. I would like to take a moment to recognize the many civic leaders that are here. As I call your name, please briefly stand up. It's important that we acknowledge your presence for taking time from your busy schedule to be present at this graduation. Please hold your applause until the end of the introductions. From San Benito County Sheriff's Office, Commander Mike Kirschman. San Mateo County Sheriff's Office, Under Sheriff Christopher Chung. And also Executive Consultant Paul Kunkel. From the Santa Clara County Sheriff's Office, Sheriff Bob Johnson. Under Sheriff Ken Binder. Assistant Sheriff Michael Doty. Assistant Sheriff Dahlia Rodriguez. Assistant Sheriff David Sepulveda. Director of Administrative Services, T. Dang. Thank you all for being here. To all the family and friends with us here today, you are the reason these recruits have accomplished their goals. You've been a support system for the recruits throughout their amazing journey, and for that, we thank you. Let us all give them the round of applause that they deserve. Ladies and gentlemen, will you all please stand? I now have the honor of introducing you to the Santa Clara County Justice Training Center Corrections Academy, Class 27. Please remain standing for the presentation of the colors. We will now have the presentation of the national anthem by Law Enforcement Clerk Rosie Dominguez.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you, Ms. Dominguez. Everyone, please be seated. At this time, I would like to ask the Correctional Academy Coordinator, Sergeant Raul Marta, to come to the podium for the passing of the guidon.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome and thank you. I'm Sergeant Raul Marta, the Academy Coordinator for Class 27. The guidon has been a symbol of camaraderie and speed the corps for both the military and the police through history. Each guidon symbolizes something unique for each class it represents, and it is a result of the hopes and ideas of all the recruits. With today's transfer of the class guidon, Class 27's legacy will live on at the Justice Training Center. It will serve as a symbol of inspiration to all future recruits, and it ties today's graduates to past and future academies. I would like to welcome you, all of you, to the celebration of what is a major accomplishment for those seated upon this stage today, and one that has challenged them to push past every limit they thought they had. I'm sure the family and friends here today have seen firsthand the commitment, the discipline, and the fortitude required of all these recruits. During the past 16 weeks, this academy confronted them with many challenges. These recruits completed more than 640 hours of academy training and spent countless hours at home completing homework and preparing for what each new day had in store for them. State standards require each recruit to complete multiple behavior and written skills tests, which assess an individual's ability in defensive tactics, physical endurance, communication skills, report writing, mental illness, crisis intervention, and de-escalation techniques. The training was accomplished while dealing with setbacks and exposure mitigating measures due to the COVID-19 pandemic, but the members of Class 27 never became unmotivated and have continued to strive forward. The members of Class 27 demonstrated through testing and through hands-on scenarios that they have acquired the knowledge and skills taught to them in this academy and can safely, effectively, and ethically carry out the duties as correctional deputies and officers. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to introduce the class president for Class 27, Recruit Arnell Lamigo.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you all for being here and sharing this important milestone. This day marks the beginning of Class 27's career in law enforcement. I am so grateful and humbled by the support, inspiration, and leadership from everyone gathered here today. This accomplishment could not have been achieved without the strength of our community. To our friends and family, thank you for your continued support throughout the academy. I know many of us needed a lot of it, from making our lunches, shopping for our very specific items we needed for academy, or just lending and listening ear. We thank you for caring for us and encouraging us all along the way. I know we cannot have been the easiest to deal with for the past 4 months, and today validates your hard work too. There is so much thanks that our class has to give. To our command staff and academy instructors, since our very, very incredibly warm welcome on day one, your guidance and leadership have been paramount in our success throughout the academy. Though it may have been hard to see through the blood, sweat, and tears that we poured out on that parade deck, the valuable training and experience we have received from you have improved us far beyond what we imagined possible. We're thankful to have such a skillful team of selfless academy instructors and volunteers that have prepared us to enter our careers in law enforcement. Lieutenant Lara, thank you for always encouraging us and encouraging our class and reminding us to constantly look forwards towards achievement. Your motivating and compassionate speeches throughout the academy really helped us persevere during tough milestones, even just surviving our first week. Thank you for your leadership and ensuring that we got the best training possible. So Sergeant Marta, thank you for being so involved in our training. You showed us such a high level of investment in our work, and your high expectations brought out the best in us. Not only that, but to see you side by side with us training at every challenging PT session was inspiring. Thank you for your commitment to coordinating and raising the bar for an outstanding training program. Recruit Training Officer Garcia, thank you for the dedication you had in shaping us up. You did not let us get away with the easy route, and you challenged us to figure out tough situations. Your guidance and help was always present, ensuring that we would not fail. No matter how tough training would get, you motivated us to come back each day and do better. Thank you for teaching us that dedication is truly the key to success. Recruit Training Officer Cornell, thank you for the knowledge that you continually impressed upon us. You showed us through your own actions how important academics and knowledge of policy is crucial to being in law enforcement. Your pep talks before major test days or physical challenges instilled in us the discipline to maintain calm during moments of fear and frustration. Thank you for teaching us that no matter what we face, to stand up strong and to see it through. We as a class would truly not be where we are today without the work of all of our instructors of Class 27. Those 4 months felt like 4 years. But it seems like it was just yesterday when we pulled up to the gates of the Justice Training Center. Under the stress and frustrations of week one, it seemed that we would never see eye to eye, let alone work together. And I'm so glad that we couldn't have been farther from the truth. Many of us could not see the importance of teamwork from the start, but as each week passed, we learned how valuable it is to give support and to be open to receiving it. I'm honored to have worked and grown alongside all of you. One of the greatest lessons I've taken away from this experience at the Academy is that we must all do our part to help each other succeed. We can't go far alone. There'll be times when we must stand up and be leaders, and there will be times when we must support others who lead. Accepting our individual flaws and embracing our strength of our community and teamwork is what has gotten us this far and what will continue to drive us forward. So Class 27, remember, through whatever obstacles lie ahead, see it through. You have each other's support if you should falter, but never give up. The challenges have only just begun. It's time for us to step up and do our part in serving next to the great men and women who have come before us. Class 27, congratulations to us all. Let's enjoy this day that we've worked so hard to reach. And as we move on, let's carry ourselves with confidence and humility as we enter the next phase of our careers. Continue to build upon your training and prove that regardless of how often we are tested, we will always be ready. Thank you for the honor and privilege of being your class president. At this time, I would like to present Class 27's video.
Sleepy eyes, heavy heart with a heavy mind. People talk, but I don't lie. Little bro, in the court, he's facing life. Fire arms, foreign cars, he's down to ride. Be the charge, be the odds, trying to live this life. Sacrifices that I made for the money. All the shit that we did for the money. All the times we jogged in the rain for the money. All the wins and all the losses on the roads. And I used to pull up to my knees on the roads. All rainy days, pedal bike and a cold. All nowadays it ain't that, nowadays it's all life.
My view from the top of the moon. I can see the whole world sitting in my hand, amazing view. We finna break the rules, and we gon' make them too. I can't fall asleep, I gotta stand tall, that's what a leader do. Follow me, I'm leading you. Ay, we finna turn up, crank up the heat in here, they finna burn up. Told them I'm coming, I'm here, tell them they time up. I said it once, I'ma say it again, this here be my year. I ain't gon' show no fear, I know that I'm built to equip for what God want me to do. I'm number one out the two, it don't know where I'ma lose. I hate to struggle, but it made me harder. I made it far, but I wanna go farther. This not for me, this for my son and my daughter. My family tree in that order. I'm the chosen one, I'm wearing that jacket. I was down, now I'm up, now I was the underdog. Now look who be left, I'm better than you guess, yeah.
The champions. Hey, we gon' bow, never fall. The champions. Hey, we gon' bow, never fall. I put my head up and told them crown me. My ring finger got a rock on it, rock on it. I put my head up and told them crown me.
Get up, get up, get up, get up. Came with a weak split up. I got your weak hitters. I'ma go keep I got the vision and it's panorama. I grew my faded tea, I basically made it out of Atlanta. When the closest thing to tropic was the Tropicana. Yeah, yelling for the guys, born for the guys. To my dog, 50 on the other side. Pop me one, pop me two, pop me three.
Another one.
Celebrate for the ones we lost, yeah. Celebrate with the ones we got, yeah.
Drive a sane man bizzer. Not to worry, Mr. Ace to the Izzles back to Wizard.
How do you console my mom?
Or give her light support? Telling her son's on life support. And just imagine how my girl feel. On the plane, scared as hell that a guy looked like Emmett Till. She was with me before the deal. She been trying to be mine. She a Delta, so she been throwing that dynasty sign. No use me trying to be lying. I've been trying to be signed. Trying to be a millionaire. How I use two lifelines. In the same hospital with Biggie Smalls died. The doctor said I had blood clots, but I ain't Jamaican, man. Story on MTV, and I ain't trying to make a band. I swear this right here, history in the making, man.
I really apologize for this one right now, if it's unclear at all, man. They got my mouth wired shut for like, I don't know, the doctor said like 6 weeks. You know, I had reconstructive surgery on my jaw. I looked in the mirror, half of my jaw was in the back of my mouth, man. I couldn't believe it. But I'm still here for y'all right now, man. This is what I got to say right here, though.
Yeah, turn me up, yeah. What if somebody from the shadow was ill? Got a deal on the hottest rap label of Brown. But he wasn't talking about coke and birds. It was more like spoken word. Except he's really putting it down. And he explained the story about how blacks came from glory and what we need to do in a game. Good dude, bad night, right place, wrong time. In the blink of an eye, his whole life changed. If you could feel how my face felt, you would know how Mace felt. Thank God I ain't too cool for the safe belt. I swear to God, drive a 2-1-2. I got a lawyer for the case to keep us in my safe. My dogs couldn't tell if I looked like Tom Cruise on Vanilla Sky. It was televised.
It's been an accident like Geico. They thought I was burned up like Pepsi did Michael. I must got an angel, cause look how death missed is unbreakable. What you thought they call me, Mr. Glass? Look back on my life like the ghost of Christmas.
At this time, I would like to present the award for Most Inspirational Instructor. This instructor has spent several weeks with the class and was instrumental in the development of our knowledge in behavioral health and crisis intervention. On behalf of Class 27, We would like to thank him for his hard work and dedication to our training. Please help me recognize Deputy Stephen Blatt.
Wow. You know, it's been a real honor being at the Academy so many times, thanks to my command staff allowing me to be there to watch you mold into the deputies you will be. And my small portion that I played in that is a deep honor. I really do appreciate this. And congratulations on allowing me to be here for your very special day. Thank you.
As you can see, the recruits were immersed into a world which challenged them physically, mentally, and emotionally, with a high demand for self-discipline and accountability. The recruits were not only challenged with exam and exercises designed to evaluate the recruits' competency, but they also had to balance their personal lives. These recruits were challenged physically, mentally, emotionally, and exposed to stress inoculation all academy long, because eventually these recruits are going to encounter a stressful critical incident. When that time comes, they will be able to revert back to their training and make it home to their families safe. While the efforts of the recruits are certainly a large factor in their own success, these recruits did not face these challenges alone. None of it would be possible without the efforts of our academy staff, the incredible dedicated instructors and volunteers who committed themselves to ensuring that the recruits had every resource and opportunity to be competent and successful throughout the academy. The guidance and expertise and wisdom of these instructors was essential to a successful academy training program. They have provided lessons to the recruits that they will carry their entire careers. I personally cannot thank them enough for all they have done. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in giving our instructors and volunteers a round of applause. I would like now to introduce the keynote speaker for Class 27, Santa Clara County's Assistant Sheriff, David Sepulveda.
Good afternoon, everybody, and good afternoon, Class 27. It is my sincere honor and pleasure to be here with you today to celebrate the members of Class 27 and their amazing accomplishments. This achievement was not easy. It's not an easy undertaking, as this academy provides some of the best and most comprehensive training for corrections nationwide. It warms my heart to see all of you proud family members, friends, and loved ones here today in support of Class 27. This is important, because your support is what got them here, got them through the difficult phase of their career, and what will get them through what's to come. So thank you. Your support truly means very much. To Class 27, I'm honored to have been given the opportunity to speak with you today as you get ready to embark on the next chapter of your profession and your life. On December 1st, 1989, a little over 33 years ago, I was sitting at my own academy graduation in a formation very similar to how you're sitting today. Also listening to speeches, anxiously awaiting to take my oath of office and to have my badge pinned. I just couldn't wait to get on the job. I was excited and eager. Although much time has passed since then, a few more pounds, a little less hair, I can honestly say that I'm still excited and eager to come to work every day. This is because our profession, corrections, is about people. It's about making a difference in our community through giving people the best opportunity to better their lives when all else has failed them. I can share with you that our agency has remained one of the nation's leaders in custody rehabilitative programs for over three decades. With your help, we will continue our endless commitment to evolve for the betterment of those who we care for. If you're among the graduates of one of our fine allied agencies, know that your agency has the same endless commitment, and they will be relying on you to help achieve their rehabilitative goals. Taking this journey is truly a life-changing experience, one that you can navigate as you progress through your career. From this point forward, your everyday decisions and choices are the stones that pave your path, a path that is created with each action you take or don't take, both personally and professionally. Please know this is a path that you will not walk alone. The decisions you make in this career will affect the lives of others, sometimes in small ways and other times quite considerably. Whether it affects them positively or not is truly up to you in the moment. This is the massive responsibility that you have chosen to accept. You must never take that responsibility lightly or believe that this responsibility belongs to someone else. It is yours alone to bear. So please understand unequivocally that your choices do matter every day and every moment. If you're asking yourself why your choices are going to be so important, let me share my thoughts with you. In your new role, you will be responsible for providing the custody and care of those in your charge. But what exactly does that mean, custody and care? I think most people who don't work in corrections would reasonably conclude the custody portion means keeping offenders in the jail until they're officially released, performing daily tasks such as counts, searches, and security checks. And I think they will equally believe that the care component means providing food, shelter, clothing, and medical care as needed. On the surface, those assumptions are all true. Others make assumptions based on what they see in the news, TV shows, movies. TV shows and movies often portray correctional deputies not as professionals, but as knuckle-dragging jail guards, unethical opportunists, physical abusers, and even criminals. For those in our profession, we have quietly endured these absurd depictions for decades. All the while, corrections has continued to evolve into something better with each passing year. We have continued on our mission to make positive differences in the lives of others. So please don't let these portrayals derail your course. Know that most people do not have the fortitude to do your job. Your chosen profession is noble and just. I suppose these depictions make for good TV, but they couldn't be further from the truth. The truth is, correctional deputies are our unsung heroes. Your role is far more complex and significant than what is perceived by the community. Every single day, you will be assisting people who are often at the lowest point in their life, in their worst state of mind, or diagnosed with a serious mental illness. They lash out, cause chaos, and may even try to hurt us. Regardless, we continue to perform our duties. We do so willingly, without reservation or trepidation, every single day. What people also don't know is that your daily work will include helping people overcome their addictions, being a role model, a motivator, and sometimes a counselor, safely assisting those who are withdrawing from alcohol or drugs, watching over those who are suicidal and preventing suicides, de-escalating those who are angry, using communication, not force, protecting the meek from the predators, preventing fights, disturbances, and sometimes escapes. That's the E word we don't use very often. You'll be assisting people with their daily living activities when they have mobility or cognitive disabilities, facilitating access to medical, mental health, and dental care and treatment, facilitating education, rehabilitation, and vocational programs to help a person better their life, to give them the best chance to succeed when they're released. You will be the first to respond to medical emergencies and provide first aid. You will save lives in your career, either through providing preservation of life actions like performing CPR, administering Narcan to an overdose victim, or by taking immediate steps to get somebody the help they need. Correctional deputies in our facility submit over 2,000 mental health and medical referrals to our custody health partners every month. These are just some of the amazing things that you'll be doing in your new career. With all that being said, I know you're all excited to get to work. But before you do, I want to ask you to do me a favor. Please silently take the following pledge: that you will make respect and compassion the guiding light of your path, that personal success will never be the driving force of your service. Rather, the success of others is what you will seek, that the needs of the community we serve will always be in the forefront of your decisions, that you will only use force that is necessary and never out of malice, spite, or anger, that you will be rational, fair, and consistent every day to everyone, that you will serve with honor and integrity always, and most importantly, that you make it a priority to maintain your personal wellness and the wellness of your family, because you can't meet any of these expectations unless you and your family are okay first. So congratulations, Class 27. I wish you a long, healthy, successful career. Stay safe and Godspeed. Thank you.
Among those who have instructed and guided these recruits, nobody has been more dedicated to their success or given as much time as a recruit training officer. Very few people know truly understand what it takes to be a recruit training officer. They are the first ones on campus and the last to leave. They by far have the most interaction with the recruits. The recruit training officer is the most crucial role in a recruit's experience because the RTOs have many responsibilities. They have to be mentors, they have to be role models, instructors, motivators, and disciplinarians. Fortunately, we have two great RTOs who have made the success of this class their first and top priority, often at times at the expense of their own personal family time. It has been my privilege and honor to work with them. Please join me in a round of applause as I invite RTO Andre Cornell and RTO Alberto Garcia to the podium.
Greetings, everyone, and thank you for coming. The Justice Training Center would like to acknowledge several recruits that went above and beyond during their time at the Academy by presenting them with an award. The first award is the Top Academic Award. This recruit excelled in numerous areas at the Academy. This recruit demonstrated excellent critical thinking ability and report writing skills. This recruit has the highest combined score on their multiple choice tests and quizzes. I would like to present the Top Academic Award to recruit Sabrina Avila. The second award is the Top Practical Award. This recruit maintained one of the best scenario and defensive tactics scores amongst all the recruits. I would like to present the Top Practical Award to recruit Alejandro Maldonado Rojas. The third award is for the Top Overall Recruit. This recruit was at or near the top of the class in all years during the Academy. Due to this recruit's performance throughout the Academy, he will now graduate with the highest seniority of the class. I would like to present the Top Overall Recruit Award to recruit Arnell Lamigo. The last award is the Leadership Award. Throughout the course of the academy, the recruits are put into various leadership positions within their class. Some of these positions are chosen by the recruit training officers, and others are chosen by their fellow recruits. The Leadership Award goes to the recruit who demonstrated strong leadership ability and had a positive impact on the class. This award was decided by a class vote. The Leadership Award goes to recruit Steve Amaya.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We would like to take a moment to give a special acknowledgement to all the brave men and women of the United States Armed Forces, former and current. Would the following recruits please stand as I call your name? Please hold your applause until the end. Thank you. Recruit Amaya. Recruit Amaya served 5 years in the United States Army Reserve component with the 397th Engineering Battalion, 801st Engineering Company as a horizontal construction engineer. He earned multiple awards such as the National Defense Service Medal, Army Service Ribbon, Army Achievement Medal, Army Certificate of Achievement. He continues his service with the United States Army Reserve, holding the rank of E4 Specialist. Recruit Gabriel. Recruit Gabriel has served 3.5 years in United States Marine Corps Reserves with 2nd Battalion, 23rd Marine Regiment as an infantry squad leader. He served in Operation Allies Welcome, where he helped Afghan refugees transition into a new life in America. He has earned multiple awards such as the Armed Forces Reserve Medal, Armed Forces Service Medal, Global War on Terrorism Medal, National Defense Medal, and selected Marine Corps Reserve Medal. He continues his service with the United States Marine Corps Reserves, holding the rank of E4 Corporal. Recruit Gonzalez. Recruit Gonzalez served 4.5 years in the United States Marine Corps with the 1st Marine Division, 3rd Light Armed Reconnaissance Battalion. During his term in the Marine Corps, he was attached to the Explosive Ordnance Disposal Unit, where he was awarded the EOD badge for his service. He was also part of the commissioning detail of the USS San Diego. He was a division Marine who had the privilege to escort fallen Marines' remains to their families. During his service, Recruit Gonzalez has received awards such as a Navy and Marine Corps Achievement Ribbon, Sea Service Deployment Ribbon, National Defense Service Medal, Global War on Terrorism Service Medal, 4th Award Expert Rifle Badge, and Expert Pistol Badge. He has received an honorable discharge with the rank of E4 Corporal. Recruit Jones. Recruit Jones served 5 years in the United States Navy. She received the Basic Honor Graduate Ribbon Award and Basic Training. She was stationed on the CVN 71 USS Theodore Roosevelt as an aviation boatsman's mate. She was tasked with this important job of launching and recovering naval aircraft on the flight deck. She finished her term at NAS Lemoore as a training officer. She was awarded the Good Conduct Medal, Global War on Terrorism Service Medal, National Defense Service Medal, Navy Pistol Sharpshooter Ribbon. She received an honorable discharge with the rank of E4 Petty Officer. At this time, I would like to ask all those who have served and are currently serving in the military to please stand up and be recognized for your hard-fought efforts to keep our country safe and protected.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time to present our recruits with their graduation certificates and their official agency badge. We will announce the name of the recruit and the name of the person who will be pinning the badge. When your recruit's name is called, please come forward to the center aisle and you will receive the badge to pin your recruit.
At this time, I would like to invite Lieutenant Lara and Sergeant Fernandez to assist in the badge presentation to the graduates. Command staff for San Benito County, would you please make your way to the backdrop at the end, take a picture with your recruit. Thank you. Recruit Lemus. Penny Recruit Lemus will be his mother, Kimberly Lemus. Recruit Lemus chose his mother because of her endless support and always believing in him. Recruit Lemus is from Gilroy, California. Prior to this, Recruit Lemus worked as a security guard for the United States Patent and Trademark Office. Recruit Lemus' hobbies include spending time with his family and friends, traveling with his girlfriend, and taking their dogs to the beach. Command staff from San Mateo County Sheriff's Office, would you make your way to the backdrop to take a picture with your recruit? Thank you. Recruit Lamigo. Penny Recruit Lamigo will be his wife, Jessica. Recruit Lamigo chose his wife because she has been his biggest supporter and source of motivation. Recruit Lamigo is from Fremont, California. He was previously a gym owner and a fitness coach. Some of his interests include spending time with his family, powerlifting, and Brazilian jiu-jitsu. Recruit Maldonado. Penny Recruit Maldonado will be his girlfriend, Carol Berrigan. Recruit Maldonado chose his girlfriend because she gave him unconditional support, guidance, and positive encouragement throughout the academy. Recruit Maldonado was born in Guanajuato, Mexico, and grew up in Martinez, California. Recruit Maldonado worked as a general manager and creative director at a San Jose powerlifting gym for 4 years. Recruit Maldonado enjoys backpacking and playing his guitar on his free time. Command staff from Santa Clara County Sheriff's Office, would you make your way to the backdrop to take a picture with your recruit? Thank you. Recruit Amaya. Penny Recruit Amaya will be his brother, Jose. Recruit Amaya chose his brother because he was the reason he initially wanted to join law enforcement. And he was always inspired. He always inspired him to work hard throughout the academy. Recruit Amaya is originally from San Jose, California. Prior to this, Recruit Amaya worked construction at his father's company. Recruit Amaya's hobbies include working out, being with friends and family, and learning something new whenever possible. Recruit Avila. Penny Recruit Avila will be her father, Ben Vera. Recruit Avila chose her father because she was inspired by her father's hard work and drive. Recruit Avila's attributes, much of who she is because of her father, and she thanks him for his dedication to her family. Recruit Avila is from San Jose, California. Prior to the academy, Recruit Avila attended school at San Jose State University and obtained her bachelor's degree in justice studies. She worked at Costco for 11 years before leaving to fulfill a career in law enforcement. In her spare time, Recruit Avila likes to spend time with her family, eat her mom's amazing food, and go for walks with her dog.
Recruit Gabriel. Pinning Recruit Gabriel will be his parents, Misael Gabriel and Araceli Jimenez. Recruit Gabriel chose his parents because he wouldn't be here without them. They have always worked really hard and have made many sacrifices to ensure him a good future. Recruit Gabriel was born in Oaxaca, Mexico, and moved to Gilroy when he was 10 years old. Prior to the academy, Recruit Gabriel was a security officer while attending college. In his spare time, Recruit Gabriel likes to mountain bike, go fishing, go to the gym, work on cars, and go on runs with his dog. Recruit Gallegos. Pinning Recruit Gallegos will be her parents, Laura Soto and Julian Gallegos. Recruit Gallegos chose her parents because she is inspired by their hard work, their sacrifices, their mentorship, and their unconditional love and support. Recruit Gallegos was born and raised in Visalia, California. Before the academy, she was attending school at Fresno State, California, where she received her bachelor's degree in criminology with a minor in sociology. She worked as a clerk at a Best Buy warehouse. In her spare time, Recruit Gallegos likes to spend time with her family and friends, travel, hike, go shopping, dance, and exercise. Recruit Gonzalez. Pinning Recruit Gonzalez will be his mother, Anna Sloan, and his wife, Andrea. Recruit Gonzalez chose his mother, Anna, because she has always been strong and resilient and has given him everything to succeed. And his wife, Andrea, for always being by his side supporting him. Recruit Gonzalez is from Santa Clara, California. Prior to this academy, he worked for Amazon. On his spare time, Recruit Gonzalez likes to spend time with his family, pets, cook, and work out.
Recruit Guerra. Pinning Recruit Guerra will be her father, Anthony. Recruit Guerra chose her father because he always gave her the inspiration to the best in everything she does and to never quit something she starts. She was born and raised in Gilroy, California. Prior to the academy, she attended San Jose State University, where she earned her BS in kinesiology. Following college, she worked as a notary public. During her free time, she enjoys going on hikes, spending time with her family, and playing basketball. Recruit Jones. Pinning Recruit Jones will be her brothers, Jeremy, Victor, and Chris. Recruit Jones chose her brothers because they have always pushed her to be the best version of herself. Jeremy has always been a father figure to her, and her brothers have always been her heroes. She was born and raised in San Jose, California. Prior to the academy, she served in the United States Navy. On her spare time, Recruit Jones likes to spend time with her husband, playing dress up with her daughters, singing karaoke, and binge watching Netflix. Recruit Gerardo. Pinning Recruit Gerardo will be his sister, Megan. Recruit Gerardo chose his sister because his sister was a former deputy in corrections and understands the amount of hard work it takes to be in this career. He was born in Santa Clara, California. Prior to the academy, he was an equipment maintenance technician. On his spare time, Recruit Gerardo likes to spend time with his friends and family, attend concerts and sporting events, traveling, and working out. Recruit Lascano. Pinning Recruit Lascano will be his father, Gustavo Lascano Sr. Recruit Lascano chose his father because he is inspired by the things his father has achieved and the life his father was able to give him and his sister because of his hard work and no excuses mentality. Recruit Lascano was born in Long Beach, California, and raised in Morgan Hill. Prior to the academy, he was a security manager. On his spare time, he likes to spend time with his son and fiance, attend family gatherings, and go to the gym. Recruit Lamelli. Pinning Recruit Lamelli will be his girlfriend, Veronica Cedillo, and son, Ernesto Lamelli Jr. Recruit Lamelli chose his girlfriend because she has always motivated him to strive and be the best version of himself and to never give up on his dreams. He was born in San Diego and raised in Salinas, California. Prior to the academy, he was a driver for Mission Trail Waste Systems for the County of Santa Clara. During his free time, he likes to go to the gym, explore the outdoors, and spend a lot of his time visiting Yosemite and other national parks with his family. Recruit Munoz. Pinning Recruit Munoz will be his daughters, Camila and Jimena. Recruit Munoz chose his kids because as a child, he was able to pin his mother, Rachel Munoz, for the Gilroy Police Department and remembers what an honor it was to pin her. Recruit Munoz wants his daughters to know the same proud feeling he experienced and hopes to instill the same feeling of pride as he knew as a young boy. Recruit Munoz was born and raised in Gilroy, California. Prior to the academy, Recruit Munoz worked at NASA Ames Research Center as a federal security officer. In his spare time, Recruit Munoz enjoys spending time with his wife and kids, going on bike rides, hikes, hitting the gym, and going on vacation. Recruit Rodriguez. Pinning Recruit Rodriguez will be his father, Kenneth. Recruit Rodriguez chose his father because he is blessed to have a loving father that dedicated his life to give Recruit Rodriguez and his siblings everything they needed to succeed in life. He was born in San Jose, California. Prior to the academy, he worked as an armored service technician for Loomis, a cash handling company. In his spare time, Recruit Rodriguez likes to spend time outdoors with family and friends, riding his mountain bike, camping, and finding new hiking trails with his girlfriend. Recruit Ruiz. Pinning Recruit Ruiz will be his mother, Simona and Kristen. Recruit Ruiz chose his mother and girlfriend because without her love and support and encouragement, he would not have been able to get through these tough times. Recruit Ruiz was born in San Jose, but moved to Riverbank at the age of 7 and has lived there since. Recruit Ruiz worked as a pool technician prior to joining the academy. Recruit Ruiz likes to spend his free time lifting weights, mountain biking, playing golf, and spending time with his family and friends. Recruit Serrano. Pinning Recruit Serrano will be her son, Elias, and daughter, Valentina. Recruit Serrano chose her son and daughter because they are her motivation, and if it wasn't for her children, she wouldn't have been here. She was born and raised in San Jose, California. Prior to the academy, she was a medical unit assistant at Santa Clara County Psych Department and at O'Connor Hospital. On her spare time, Recruit Serrano likes to spend time with her family, attend her son's soccer games, and loves music and traveling.
At this time, I would like to invite San Mateo County Sheriff's Office, Under Sheriff Christopher Shung, to the podium for the oath of office.
Thank you. The recruits from the San Mateo County Sheriff's Office, please stand. Raise your right hand, please. Repeat after me. I state your name.
I
do solemnly swear that I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of California against all enemies, foreign and domestic, that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of California, that I take this obligation freely without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion, and that I will well and faithfully discharge the duties upon which I am about to enter. Congratulations.
At this time, I would like to invite Sheriff Bob Johnson to the podium to do the oath of office.
Well, this is what you've been waiting for. So go ahead and stop, rise, and raise your right hand.
Pretty impressive, aren't they? So repeat after me. I, state your name, do solemnly swear that I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States and the Constitution of the State of California against all enemies, foreign and domestic, that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the Constitution of the State, United States, and the Constitution of the State of California, that I will take this obligation freely without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion, and that I will well and faithfully discharge the duties upon which I am about to enter. Congratulations. Go ahead and see. Well, I think they all deserve a tremendous round of applause. You know, I know you want to celebrate, but there's two things that I want to share with you. Is one, I have a very warm heart being up here, seeing these men and women who have chosen this profession as their career. And it really is exciting. And the thing is that I know, based on their motto of often tested, always ready, the reason I'm so confident they will always be ready is every time I walked into a classroom, they would challenge me to push-ups. They were always ready to do them, but I'm not going to ask them to do them right now. I'm going to let you off the hook today, but there will be another day that we will have that opportunity. So I'm very proud of each and every one of you. You've deserved this. You've earned it. And I really hope that you thrive. And I know you will, not only in your personal lives, but in your careers. Thank you for joining law enforcement for whatever agency you've chosen. But I will say in ending this, I think we're going to have a tiebreaker. Because what I noticed as we were doing the badge pinning, I believe there are two Joneses that are on our department now, and there are two Joneses for the San Mateo County Sheriff's Office. And I was told there's one more Jones to join. So that will be the type, but where is that Jones right now? Okay, there she is. So we'll see where she lies. So anyway. With that, I really thank all of you for coming today, and I think we're going to have an opportunity to relax and say hello to each other out in the foray. So thank you again, and with that, I'm going to turn it back over to Lieutenant Lair.
President Calvin Coolidge once said, "No one is compelled to choose the profession of law enforcement, but having chosen it, everyone is obligated to perform its duties and live up to the high standards of its requirements." On behalf of the Santa Clara County Sheriff's Office, thank you for being here today. As we conclude the ceremony, I would like to invite all of you to join us for the refreshments in the foyer. I would also like to invite the command staff from the graduating agencies to join the Academy staff and graduates for a class picture here up on the stage. Before we do that, I would like to have a congratulatory celebration for the recruits, for the new deputies, and can we please all welcome them as graduates to the State of California Peace Officers.
Kyle, Teresa.